Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm going to give you 30 days action plan to become fluent in English. If you are at intermediate level, let me tell you very honestly, if you are someone who can write but cannot speak, then by following my 30 days plan and by just giving 1 hour every day to English, you can surely become fluent in English. Those who are beginners, they will definitely improve by following my 30 days plan. So be with me, keep watching. My name is Trilekha. I make videos on English lessons, personality development, work from home ideas, and a lot more. And you're watching my channel, Lot to Learn. A systematic approach is very much needed if you are really serious about learning English, if you really want to become fluent in English. Beginning from today, you have to give 1 hour every day to English. I have divided this 1 hour into 4 parts. First 15 minutes for reading. Next 15 minutes, we'll focus on grammar, vocabulary, or phrasal verbs as per your need. Next 15 minutes for speaking part. And last 15 minutes for listening. Now, those of you who are thinking to leave the video, just stay, don't go anywhere, because I'm gonna tell you about the most difficult part in this video, that is speaking practice. So how and where you can practice English, speaking English, okay? Now, first 15 minutes we are going to spend for reading. And you will be amazed to know that I have improved my English by reading lot of books, just lot of books. But if you're someone who do not like to read books, that's fine, no worries. You can read anything that interests you or that you find compelling. It can be magazines, it can be newspaper or anything. I'm going to tell you something that I have tried and tested on my students, especially those students who never liked reading books. So you might be aware of the book called Champak. I'm going to show it to you. This is a simple story books for kids and it cost only 35 rupees, this one. Okay, so this is actually very cheap. So why I'm recommending this book, there is a reason. I have tried this on many of the students. The language in this book is very simple, easy to understand, and extremely useful for everyday conversation. So let me read few lines for you. You will understand what I'm trying to say here. He asked the camel owner, can we hire 2 camels and ride them on our own? Agar main Hindi mein aapse poochu ki mujhe camel pe baithna hai aur khud hi camel ko मतलब मुझे कोई कैमल के साथ जो होता है पर्सन वो नहीं चाहिए, मैं खुद ही चलाना चाहूँगा, खुद ही सवारी करना चाहूँगा, कैसे बोलोगे आप इंग्लिश में? इट विल बी रियली डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू, राइट? सो कैन वी हायर 2 camels एंड राइड देम ऑन अवर ओन? वी वुड लाइक टू रेस ईच अदर. सो दिस इज हाउ यू विल फाइंड मेनी यूजफुल सेंटेंसेज इन दिस बुक. सो आई वुड सजेस्ट यू स्टार्ट विद दिस बिकॉज इट डजेंट नीड मच इन्वेस्टमेंट, इट इज वेरी चीप. Next 15 minutes, we will be focusing on grammar. Now, don't get scared. For speaking English, you don't need intensive grammar or deep knowledge of grammar, but you must have your basics clear. Okay, so you should not mix up present tense, past tense. You must know how to use prepositions and all. I have made many videos on present tense, past tense, prepositions, modal verbs. So if you want, you can go and check out that playlist. It will be helpful to you. If you are someone who feel that you are okay with grammar, you don't make many mistakes with grammar, or the mistakes are negligible, then wonderful. So now you have to focus on phrasal verbs. When it comes to speaking English, phrasal verbs are very much used by native speakers, but the list for phrasal verbs is quite long, so I'm gonna make it short for you. So first, what you need to do is try to focus on these phrasal verbs that I'm going to tell you. So phrasal verbs starting from come, get, go, pick and put. And I have taught all these phrasal verbs in detail on Unacademy Improve Your English channel. So you can go. There is a separate playlist there. You will find out. So there are many words, vocabulary and everything I have taught. So that would be really helpful because everything is given in detail there. So go and check out these things there. Also, do not forget to subscribe to my channel because I'm going to give you more information on this channel about all these things. here comes the most difficult part of becoming fluent in English, practicing. So the question arises with whom we should practice, where we should practice. So no worries, I have some ideas for you. In fact, these days I'm not taking my personal classes, otherwise I would have asked you to join me. I'm busy teaching English on an academy. Anyways, so there are some platforms where you can go and practice English, and some of them are free. For some, you have to pay. I would strongly recommend you to go for the paid ones, because once you pay for something, you get serious about that. And it's just a 1 month plan. So I would want you to give your best in this 1 month, and I assure you that you will get fluent after 1 month. So let me talk about the free ones first. Talk Now and Hello Now are two applications where you can get partners for free. You can go and practice. Now, the paid ones are Ingvarta, Clappingo, and Cambly. Ingvarta is the cheapest one, and I think it is good. I mean, you can go for it. They will charge some amount for 15 minutes every day, and you will get expert from all over the country. So you can talk to anyone for 15 minutes and you'll get fluent. Clappingo is, I have just seen it on the videos on YouTube, so I can't give you much feedback about it. Cambly, of course, is costly one, so I don't think everyone can afford that. So these are the options where you can go and practice. See, without practicing, you can't get fluent in any language, okay? Now, the last part of our 1 hour plan is 15 minutes for listening skills. If you listen to someone every day for 15 minutes, you will definitely learn how to use correct word, how to make correct sentences. So you can listen to anyone, any famous author, any celebrity, any famous personality. But remember, not every celebrity speaks correct English. So choose wisely, okay? Don't go for anyone's interview, otherwise you'll end up learning wrong things. So yeah, listening is definitely very effective exercise when it comes to learning English. I recommend ed.ted.com, which is a website. You can go there. There are many videos on this website on various categories. So you can find something of your interest, and there are native speakers also. So go ahead, watch videos, listen to them, and get fluent in English. So this was my 30 days plan for you to improve your English. Give 1 hour honestly and tell me after 30 days. Do come back on this video and comment and tell me about your progress. I'll see you soon with one more video. If you like my plan, please subscribe to my channel. Please share it with your friends and family and with someone who is actually in need of this plan. I would really be thankful to you. Thank you so much for watching me.